guys, my friends call me Mer, and I am your Pandemic Book of Mormon study buddy. This chapter was a doozy, just because I was like, Nephi, why? Why is this even necessary to know?
This is hurting my brain.
But I'm gonna go through it because Nephi wrote it and God commanded him to write it, so Nephi started writing this record 40 years after arriving in the Promised Land, right? As said in chapter 11. And he didn't know that once he started writing on the big plates that God would be like, stop, make small plates and write in those. Also, shout out to Nephi for being so good at metalworking. He can make tools and he made all these plates of brass. Super cool skill. Should start a University of Nephi and pass on all this knowledge. So, as I said before, we're reading in the small plates right now. So I'm going to save you a headache. First Nephi chapter 19. The small plates. God told him to keep the ministries. Ministries remind me of the word to minister, which means to help. So the ministries and the prophecies, the plain and precious truths would be in this as well. And they would be passed to the people of the land to teach them. For a purpose only God knows. And the big plates have Laban's records, which means that it has like the five books of Moses, the law of Moses, Lehi's genealogy, and the Old Testament, aka the Torah. Nephi and Lehi's prophecies, Lehi's record, the wars and contentions and destructions of his people, and these records would be passed on from generation to generation or from one prophet to another until further instruction from the Lord. You're welcome. And Nephi says he doesn't write anything in these plates unless he thinks it is sacred. So he's just repeating himself from chapter 6 when he says that he doesn't care about the world and he just wants to keep his record for spiritual purposes. Boom. And he goes on. Thank you. I like this part because you can feel his guilt. Because even though he's an amazing man, he still looks inward and he sees his faults and he knows he can be better. He wants to be better. So he says, I do not make excuses for myself. I do blame the natural man in me, the man of flesh. Because some things that people deem worthy and important and good for both body and soul, others treat like nothing and trample their feet all over it. Yea, they even trample over the God of Israel. I say trample, but I should use other words. They treat him like he's nothing and ignore all of his counsels. But according to the angel, he's coming, right? 600 years from the time my father left Jerusalem, the Messiah will come. And the world, because of their iniquities, they will judge him like he is nothing. They will whip him, and he'll suffer it. They'll hit him, and he'll suffer it. They'll spit on him, and he will suffer it because of his loving kindness and long suffering for the children of men. And then Nephi goes on to explain that Jesus Christ is the God of the Old Testament, that he was the God of their fathers who led them out of Egypt, who preserved them in the wilderness, that he is the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that it's the same guy. And then he continues to quote other prophets that were found in Laban's records. He says that the God of Abraham yields himself, according to the words of the angel, as a man into the hands of wicked men, to be lifted up, according to the words of Zenoch, and to be crucified, according to the words of Neum, and to be buried in the sepulcher after 3 days of darkness, which will be a sign of his death unto the house of Israel. Whenever I hear house of Israel, I'm not just thinking of the Jews, I'm thinking also of all of the Native Americans from North America, South America, Central America, all these other places, okay? And then he continues with Zenos's words. And it's long, so I'm just going to give the gist. So the Lord God will come to the house of Israel, some with his voice because of their righteousness, and it will cause them great joy and salvation. Yay! And he will come to others in lightnings and thunders, in storm, in smoke and vapor of darkness, and by the opening of the earth and earthquakes. And mountains will be carried up, and it is surely going to happen. And many of the kings of the isles of the sea will feel the spirit and will shout, the God of nature suffers. So Zenos is saying that just like always, God has communicated with his children through nature. And when people are wicked, he lets them know through storms, through earthquakes, through fires, and vapor of darkness. Like when Christ died, remember there were 3 days of darkness because God was not happy that his beloved son was crucified and he wanted to let everyone know. So he sent a sign. But it's up to us to recognize it. And what's amazing is that some cultures and traditional beliefs really believe in Mother Nature. So it's really cool that Zenas is like putting it together and saying, they're that same God. And as for the Jews of Jerusalem, the world will not let them forget that they crucified the God of Israel. And they reject all the signs that Jesus is the Messiah. Well, as we know, as I've said in chapter 14 about the law of Moses and how Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, there were signs. There were totally signs. And the Jews will wander in the flesh and perish.
Spiritually.
And become hated by all the nations. But one day, they will be woke. And they'll accept Jesus as the Redeemer and as the promised Messiah and the Holy One of Israel. And the Holy One of Israel will keep his end of the bargain and will bless them. And he will also remember the people of the Isles of the Sea. And I'm assuming that Zenas isn't actually saying just all islands, only islands. I'm assuming that he means like everyone across the sea from where they were in Jerusalem, you know, the oceans or whatever. But that's me. And the Lord God said, all the people of the house of Israel will I gather in from the four quarters of the earth. And all the world will have salvation in the Lord. Every nation, family, tongue, and people will be blessed. You get blessings. And you get blessings. Everybody gets blessings. So the Nephi, because he is making a compilation of all of his favorite things from different prophets, he says that he read to his brothers some parts of Isaiah to help them understand and believe in the Lord their Redeemer. And he read to them of the books of Moses. But now he's quoting Isaiah 48. Yo, house of Israel, listen to the prophets. Hey, branch that has been broken off, listen to the words of the prophets, which were written for the house of Israel, and apply them to yourselves. So you can have hope, just like your brothers from whom you have been broken off. That's what he said. End scene. So I recorded this video twice. I've had a spiritual experience with this chapter, and I wanted to include the other recording. Because in a previous chapter, I read something that it struck me, and it kind of sounded like Heavenly Father wanted a certain people to fail. So I was trying to understand it, trying to make sense of it for the past like 2-3 weeks, and I was coming up with nothing. And it's really so crazy because for the past 2-3 weeks, I've like everything has just been going wrong. And like I've been more angry and like I've had friendship issues, you know, in this pandemic. It's been really difficult. And then on top of that, like my faith was shaken and I completely stopped reading the Book of Mormon. Because, like, I was too depressed to really think of even filming or to think of editing or anything, you know? So when I did just read the next chapter, I was able to get the answer that I so desperately needed. And once I got that answer, once I read those, like, little sentences, it just all came together. And all the issues I had just kind of melted away, and like I have a new perspective, and it's a testament to how powerful this book is, that you read just one sentence and everything just clicks and your soul feels lighter and you get the answer that you need. I love this book. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Testify of these truths. Bye.